So firstly, Martin, thank you for taking some time out to do this interview. We understand you're a busy guy, but again, we really appreciate it. So let's get these questions going. You were originally scheduled to face Jeremy Pettley at BAMMA 17, December 6th at the Manchester Victoria Warehouse. You know, we'll talk about the injury a bit later on, but what were your original thoughts on that fight? How, you know, how did you feel stylistically?
I was excited about that fight because if Jeremy Pettley comes to fight, he's good in all areas. He never gives in. So that fight would have been an exciting fight for the fans to see. Stylistically, I genuinely think I'd be too much for him in any area. You know, that's not to you know, put him down at all. That's just I think I'm good enough to outdo him in any areas. It would have been a good fight, and hopefully we can get it on next year.
You know, you're both well-established guys from the UK scene. You know, you've done your thing overseas. Do you think we need kind of more of these fights over here? You know, two established UK guys going at it?
I think so, mate. You know, I'm not, I don't like to look too shit or whatever, but I find it hard to get fights against decent UK guys. You can see my last six or seven fights, they've all been international opponents.
Yeah.
I just want big fights, mate. I'll fight anyone at any time. I mean, there was a good fight on the last FCC, weren't they? Alan McLean and and the Laughlin both stepped up and took on, you know, both ways took on big opponents, and that turned out to be a great fight. So yeah, there should be more big fights that are going on, I think.
You just mentioned that you'd like to fight Pettley sometime next year. Obviously, should you get past Fournier, but again, you know, is that the fight you want next?
It's not specifically a fight that I don't get caught up on my names or anything. I just want big fights. So if Jeremy's injury allows it or whatever, I don't even know what injury he's got. You know, but what injury he has got, if the injury allows it, then it'd be nice to get it on next year, wouldn't it? I think it'd be an exciting fight for the fans. Let's do it.
So obviously Jeremy was unfortunately injured, as you just alluded to there. Your new opponent, Sebastian Fournier, a record of 8-5. Tell me what you know about him.
Nothing. Not much, really. I've been told he's got a bit of a striking background. That's about it, really. I've had, I think this is about my fourth different opponent now, so you know, I'm not really too bothered about looking up my opponents that much. My coach does all that. And I trust what my coaches tell me, so I can get on with my job.
Does it ever make you uneasy knowing that there's a late opponent change?
I'm used to it, mate. You know, it happens when you show my challenge in my career. I'm used to it now. I don't really care now. I want the big fights.
Yeah.
End of the day, someone pulls out, and someone else pulls in. What can you do? There's no problem sitting there wondering about it.
Yeah. So he's a French guy. He's obviously used to fighting French pancration rules, which, as you will know, is no elbows allowed. Do you think this gives you a disadvantage? Well, gives him a disadvantage, knowing that his last fight was fought under full MMA rules and he lost by TKO due to elbows against Timo Pakalin.
Well, you just told me something that I didn't know, though. I didn't know that. I've not even looked at his record. I don't know it. That was the case. I don't know, mate. You know what? I'm concentrating on my game. Not is. I'm sure he's in the gym training about, you know, down and down with elbows and stuff. And if not, then, you know, it's his own fault, isn't it? I can't comment on the way he's training or the way he's prepared for this fight. I just know that I prepare properly.
So moving on, obviously, to your preparation for this fight. If I'm correct, you're training at SBG currently.
Yeah, that's correct, mate. Yeah.
Yeah, how are things going down there at the minute?
It's brilliant, mate. My wife's driving me on the way there now. Yeah, it's a fantastic gym, fantastic coaches, brilliant training partners. It just couldn't be going any better at this point for me.
I spoke to Matt Inman about a month ago, obviously another SBG fighter.
Yeah.
And he said what the gym has done for him in terms of not just what how he fights in the cage, but mentally and physically is something that is just above and beyond he's used to. Could you agree with that?
Absolutely, mate. Yeah. After one match, it's like a prime example of what SBG is all about. It's not just about the fights on that night or the training. It's about the whole thing. I don't know how to explain it to you. Almost like a family thing. It's not just about that fight on that night, it's about a journey through your career. And obviously Matt's been there a long time, a lot longer than I have, so he's had that experience and that over the years, so he's a prime example of what SBG is all about. And Matt's also a guy that, you know, I look up to a lot, even though he's a, you know, he's a training partner guy, he's also someone that I look up to because he's one of them guys who everything that he's got, he's worked his bollocks off for. You know, he was doing a law degree whilst fighting full at the same time and working the doors, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's not a lot of people can do one of them things, let alone do three at the same time. It's good to have guys like him around us training, and it's good to have the coaches and stuff.
What's it like knowing that SBG, obviously one of the best, you know, MMA training camps in the country? What's it like knowing that you have the luxury of being able to use that in your fight preparation? I mentioned the mentality, the physicality, but what else do you think sets SBG above other gyms in this country?
You know, well, for me, I like I've alluded to in a few interviews, mate. For me, it's all about the methodology. There's no just like, how can I say, you know, like you train some person, you train maybe striking one day, jiu-jitsu the next, or whatever. We don't train like that. Everything comes together. Do you know what I mean? So we may be training, let's say, back takes in one session or whatever, but there'll be a reason why we've done the striking the way we've done it the day before, because it will all link together. It's not like loads of random individual stuff. It's mixed martial arts. It's not. We're not doing just individual form, individual techniques randomly. You know, the way Carl puts it together and the way John Kavanagh does it in Ireland and everything, it's holistic. It's a proper training method.
Do you think maybe we should see more of those style gyms in this country? Do you think that will help elevate, you know, the level of fighters that we're producing?
Yeah, I think so, but I think it takes a certain type of coach to be able to implement it as well.
And would you say SBG have that?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
Okay then, Mark, so moving on now, let's talk a bit about your Bellator run. Three fights, three losses, unfortunately. Why don't you think it worked out for you?
I mean, there's plenty of reasons, mate, but I've moved on from that, so, you know, I'm not too fussed about looking at the past, mate.
Well, we'll talk about the weight issues, if that's right. Obviously, you missed against Compost and your mouth. Can you explain, you know, why you struggled weight? Was it just maybe travelling, or was it just the way you cut?
Yeah, no, I think travelling a little bit to do with the weight, but, you know, when I went to featherweight fight, Yamamuchi, that's the first time I tried featherweight, but I won't be doing it again, I'll tell you that. No, it was just too low for me. By the point we got to where we got to, we just couldn't lose another pound. So, you know, we tried it. It didn't work, and I'm not going to try it again. Simple as that.
Was that your idea to fight featherweight, or did Bellator offer you that fight?
No, it was my idea. Completely my idea. You know, but you were on the move on, don't you?
Was there any specific reason you wanted to try featherweight?
Not a specific reason, no. It was just something we were going to try out at the time, you know. That's what it's about, isn't it? Trying, seeing what works and what doesn't, and that didn't.
Obviously, you're a veteran of the sport. You know, you learn from your mistakes. You know, how's weight cut going for your upcoming fight next week?
Oh, spot on. You know, I've done lightweight a million times, so all good.
So, when you're in Bellator, obviously, there was a bit of a backstage change going on. You know, you had Bjorn Rebney on the way out. By your final fight, Coker was on the way in. You know, as a fighter, could you see that internal change going on, and how does it affect you as a fighter knowing that all that's going on around you?
Nah, I didn't say any of it, mate, if I'm honest. I was there, spoke to Bjorn Redby once anyway. It's all the runners, all the guys that putting on the backstage stuff, they're the guys who do all the work for you, they're the guys that you see all the time. And they never changed, so I didn't really see any of it. I didn't have any effects on us whatsoever.
So you can see at the minute they're investing a lot of stock into British MMA fighters. You've got guys like Linton Vassell, Liam McGeary, Paul Daly. You know, what are your thoughts on that?
I don't really have any thoughts, mate. It just is what it is, and it's a business. They're obviously putting some money into that, and that's the direction they want to go in or whatever. But, yeah, I don't know, mate. I mean, good luck to Paul Daly. I hope he wins that title. That's it, yeah. I'm going to get
Do you think it's good to see UK fighters, you know, given that level of competition? Obviously, in the UFC, you know, recently, there's been there's not really been a UK standout fighter necessarily, but, you know, in Bellator, they seem to be doing pretty well for themselves. Do you think it's good that they have another platform to perform on?
Oh, yeah, good for UK MMA, definitely. I mean, you say there's been no standout from the UK in the UFC, but, I mean, Ross Pearce has been doing well for quite a while.
Yeah.
Might have been as well, and Conor's Irish, but you know, I think all the British fans get behind him anyway. But yeah, it's obviously good to have that guy getting that sort of level of competition, international fights.
Would you, you know, give any similarities between Bellator and BAMMA?
Similarities?
Yeah.
No idea, mate. If I'm honest, I've not thought about it yet. So I'll find out then. Up to this point, it's only contract negotiations.
Yeah.
We'll see on the night of the fight.
So, you know, when you signed to BAMMA, obviously, you know, did you set yourselves any goals in terms of UK MMA? Obviously, we know you've been fighting a full contact contender, but BAMMA, obviously, you know, a bit of a bigger show. You know, is there any different goals you're looking to achieve here?
Well, yeah, I mean, I've signed with BAMMA because I want to be the top lightweight in the division that they've got there. I'm going to obviously take this fight on December 6th, and then I'd like next year to get a title for the British title. Look towards getting a world title shot by the end of the year. That, you know, that's what I want to do. We spoke to BAMMA about that, told that them that that's what I want to do. So we'll see how that goes. But obviously, it all depends on me putting in the performances and winning the fights beforehand.
So obviously, as you say, you spoke to them, but them putting you against Jeremy Pettley originally obviously showed that they, you know, they had high stock in both you and
Absolutely.
Jeremy to push you high.
Yeah.
Is that something that you need as a fighter?
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah, I think, you know, you need to be with a promotion that believes in you and a promotion that's going to give you the right fight. I'm obviously doing that, putting me and Pettley together, but, you know, that fight didn't come off. But they've worked their hardest to get me new opponents. You know, they looked at David Barron. Then I don't know what happened. I think he turned the fight down or whatever. They looked at some big opponents for me, and none of them came through. So we're on our fourth or fifth opponent now. But it is what it is. But yeah, it's important that, for me, that BAMMA appreciate what I'm doing, and they're willing to put the effort in to get me decent opponents.
So the lightweight division in BAMMA is absolutely stacked, as you will know. Obviously,
yeah.
The guys, you know, you were originally scheduled to face Pettley, but you've also got guys like Mark Diakasey, Colin Fletcher, and, of course, the champion Mansour Barnawi. You know,
yeah.
Was the depth of the division something that influenced you joining the promotion?
Yeah, definitely so. Definitely, because I think, you know, BAMMA and his both have now pretty much got it sealed up with all the European lightweights, all the good ones anyway.
Yeah.
You know, that's the competition that I want. For me, anything outside that in the UK, it really isn't much competition at all, if I'm honest. No, I want the best guys in Europe to be against me on the other side of the cage.
You know, is there anyone in that division, those names I just mentioned, that you really like to go at it with?
Anyone who's got a title around the world next year. Simple as that. You know, no one in particular, but whoever's got titles next year, I want to take them out.
So, like, talking about lightweight division in the UK as a whole, obviously in Cage Warriors as well, there's Stevie Ray, he's a fantastic fighter, Joseph Duffy, you know, and in the past we've had, a plethora of great lightweight fighters, Rob Sinclair, Andre Winner. What do you think is it, you know, Ross Pearson as well, in fact, what do you think it is about the UK producing great lightweight fighters?
I don't know, but it's turning the arse, you know. There's so many good. I think it was Jamie, who was speaking about this on Facebook the other week.
Yeah.
The UK lightweight division is as good as any lightweight division in the world. You know, there's maybe 30 or 40 UK lightweights that are world class. You know, I don't think you can say that in any other division.
Yeah.
The featherweight division is good, the welterweight division is good. Outside of them, you know, it gets quite light on the ground with world-class guys, you know, your middleweights, light heavyweights, heavyweights. There's not many guys up there that you can really say they're world-class. I don't know what it is, I don't know why, but for some reason in UK, we seem to breed small or average-sized guys, but again, like little pit bulls.
Do you think there's something in the water?
It must be, yeah.
So just moving on again quickly, being an ex-Ultimate Fighter, an ex-Cage contender, an ex-Bellator guy, your name has good value attached to it, and you know, you're a seasoned fighter. Was it, you know, with this BAMMA deal, was it more about getting back into the cage, or, you know, is there ulterior motives? You know, do you want to help UK MMA grow and improve as well?
Personally, as a fighter, I just want to stay active. Bellator didn't give me that. They gave me two fights within a month, and then they made me wait out for the best part of a year. You know, it was very inactive, and it's very frustrating for me that I'm someone who likes to be, I like competition, I like to be training for a goal. Moving over to BAMMA, you know, we spoke to them about this before we signed, and they promised to keep me active. They've got a plan for me. So, from a personal perspective, yes, about getting in the cage, getting the time in, getting the fights in, staying motivated. Aside that, like you said then about helping UK MMA grow, of course, I've been doing this for like 10 years now, and I've seen it come from where we were fighting in, you know, semi-pro fights and all that, we're in workmen's clubs with the people watching. Nobody cares, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And now it's, we've got big, like this BAMMA show that's going to go on now, it's a massive venue.
Oh, yeah.
All the BAMMA shows are great venues. So yeah, I do want to see them go. And I've done that with my gym as well, you know, I've opened full contact performance in Rochdale. 3 years ago, there was only myself who was an MMA fighter in Rochdale. Now there's, I think I've got 22 fighters, you know, and all them guys have got a lot of mates, a lot of friends and family who come to watch and fight. Everyone's getting into it. There's a good buzz around Rochdale now about mixed martial arts. And then, you know, that's something that we're trying to put back into the community or the sport, whichever way you want to see it.
You know, there's a lot of UK guys, and obviously the ultimate dream is to go and fight stateside, fight in places like the UFC and Bellator. But as you mentioned there, inactivity, Bellator weren't able to give you the fights you wanted.
Yeah.
Do you think that's a problem where, you know, in the UK, there's so many promotions here? Obviously, maybe not at the level of Bellator, but you can keep fairly active. Whereas, you know, going to America, maybe fighting 2 to 3 times a year, do you think that's a problem?
Well, maybe not with the likes of the UFC. With Bellator, it was at the time that I signed. I don't know if it'll be as much of a problem for the guys now because they've put the roster right down. When I signed, it was all tournament based.
Yeah.
So that meant if you weren't on the tournament, for a UK guy, if you weren't in the tournament, they weren't interested because why are they going to fly a UK guy all the way up there to fight on a prelim fight?
Yeah.
It's not going to be shown on TV. It's not going to get any UK TV audience. They're just going to pay local, you know, local fighters from whatever the fight show is. That's why, you know, that's why they made me. And I can understand from their point of view, it's a business thing. It's all about numbers for them. But I don't think that'd be such a problem in the UFC because, you know, they put the prelim card on then they put the main card on. And I think, in general, I think the UFC are just a lot better at marketing the fighters and, it's a bigger organisation, isn't it? You know, it's a lot bigger. It's time tested, and people know it. It's a brand.
You know, obviously Bellator have moved away from those tournaments now. Do you think it's going to be harder to build up UK fighters, you know, over there? Obviously, you know, being, as you mentioned there, you know, if you're a UK fighter coming over to the US, you know, fans obviously will know less about you. And throwing you into the tournament, you know, it gives you a bit of a build-up straight away. But, you know, by not having that platform anymore, do you think that's kind of a detriment to helping UK fighters?
No, I don't, because I think that's the mistake that they made, to sign so many UK fighters, and for the reasons I said earlier, they couldn't get you the regularity of the fight.
Yeah.
So, you know, you're sat on the sidelines waiting. You know, it's all right having a contract in place being signed to someone, but if the fights aren't turning up, then, you know, the contract means nothing, basically. But now, because they've come away from that format, they've got less fighters signed to them, they've put a load of guys, they've shortened the list of fighters, and they're putting on less events, but more quality events. Maybe it'll work better. Who knows?
So moving on finally now, Martin. You know, BAMMA is going to be a huge show, as you've already mentioned. And, you know, it's going to be pretty much UK versus France in your fight. The crowd are going to be tremendously behind you. Is that something that you know, you flourish, you know, as a fighter? You love having the fans behind you in a fight?
Yeah, I mean, listen, I love the support. I love having all the fans. I really appreciate all the support. The fight's in Manchester. It's the first time I fought in Manchester. So, all the fans that are going to come from my gym and from around, it's going to be massive, and yeah, it's going to be something that I'm looking forward to. But ultimately, when you're in there and the door's closed, it comes down to you, your skills versus his skills. The fans, everything outside the cage at that point can't help you.
Yeah.
You've got to make sure your preparation's correct, your skills are correct. And I've done all that, the preparation's done, I'm ready for this fight, so. Let's get it on.
Well, Martin, I want to wish you good luck in your fight. And again, thank you very much for taking time out of your schedule to do this interview. You know, we really appreciate it.
No worries at all, Martin.